Good afternoon, welcome back to Snowdonia. We're back at our old car park.
We are having a look at going up Foel Grach today.
You'll have to excuse the wind, it is absolutely bitter. It's about a minus 8 wind chill at the moment. Minus 13 at the top, so we're getting well wrapped up. But
Scott's with us. Hello. Lucy's getting ready, purple pants Lucy.
And yeah, should be a good
bless
one.
You.
Bless you. We've got snow up on Penia Helgi Du over there. Llewellyn's off to the back there. We're heading up this one, and we're going to cross over the back to Foel Grach to the shelter.
Because the one thing we do want to do is get out of this wind when we get up there. But what's the date today?
It's about 20.
About
5th.
It's about the 25th, it's a Saturday anyway. We got up at 4 o'clock this morning, picked Scott up in Bristol on the way through, and here we are. So we've got to get a rig along because we only got about 3.5 hours of light left and a fair old climb to get up there. So yeah, hopefully we'll come along on this one and we'll see how it goes. I'll bring you back later. Welcome back. Right,
we came out of the car park from down that way. I'm just sheltering from the wind a little bit,
and we're hoping,
well, we're heading up that way where it looks a bit bleak, but we're hoping for a bit of snow today.
So like I said, sorry about the wind, not all I can do. And there's the guys disappearing off. Yeah, not a lot of snow, only 1 maybe 2 centimeters, so but it would still be nice if we got some. There was a smattering in the last couple of days, but you can just see the ground here, that's what's left down here. So yeah, hopefully Foel Grach will have the shelter to ourselves because it's only a tiny one, and I'm looking forward to the coffee already, so I'll bring you back in a little while. Well, didn't take long for the weather to change. We've got a bit of sleety hail now.
It's horrible.
Stuff that just bounces off you and gets in your eyes. Well, at least we know it'll be snow at the top, so we should get a bit today.
Oh, I've got double that amount. As you can see, weather's coming in. See it falling over there. It's dulling down, we're up against it. We've got to get right to the top before it's dark. So we're trying to get a wriggle on. We've always got the option of coming back to the Bothy, which is down there. We're going to visit that tomorrow, I think, now. But you can just see it disappearing. So, onwards through this lot.
Painful hailstones. That's that weather I was just pointing out, it's caught up with us. The view's disappeared. We knew this would be a tester.
Poor old Marley, all stuck on him. It's his eyes I worry about in this.
Well, hi guys, right, we've reached the lake.
We've got to make our way round there and up now. And it's just up there we've got to get to. What a great little pitch if you ever feel like coming up here and not doing the whole climb. Just next to that concrete slab. Look at that, it's dead flat that.
Hello, welcome back. We are just having a 10-minute break at the lake. But look,
beautiful and bright over there. And where we're headed. Dun, dun, dun. About an hour.
Hopefully an hour of light left. We should get up there with enough time just to set up the tents, maybe. If not, I don't mind setting it up under torchlight. I just don't want to walk up in the dark. So yeah, it's been good this. As you can see, nearly dark. We're
we're heading off. We're 30 metres from the shelter. Very windy, very cold, white out nearly. At least it's not snowing at the moment. But yeah, we're 400 yards and 30 metres vertical from the shelter, so not too bad. Just got to keep this lot in sight, really. Don't know how much of this you can see, and excuse the wind, but we've finally reached the shelter. There it is. So, I'll bring you back when we're inside.
Right, here we are in the Bothy. Well, shelter, tiny. Scott's jacket up there drying. There's all our bags. I can't really. Should show you with the torch, shouldn't I? There we go. We're all making coffees and
we need it.
Getting over that climb. But this was the first one of the day, so. But very damp, very cold in here.
You haven't shown them outside yet.
Yeah, let's have a look outside.
Mind your head on that door, remember last
year? How do you get out of there? There we go. There we go.
Wow, that's horrible. I'm camping out here tonight.
Right.
Oh. Why it work like that? Gosh.
Come on, Marley. Cool.
What do you reckon then?
Yeah, pretty cool. Pretty wintry, isn't it though?
Yep.
Craig Charles on the radio. Damp down jackets and stuff drying out up there. And dinner time. I'm having a new type oriental chicken with rice, used and endorsed by Sir Ranulph Fiennes. Chicken tikka masala you're having. I'm having oriental chicken. And we're using snow for water because we didn't carry much up and there's loads of it out there. He's got sorted out all his mattress and stuff. Cool. Marley's alright. You okay, Marley? Good boy. Got his warm winter summit jacket on. You can tell it must be winter because Lucy's heating the wine up and it's steaming. Scott just had a nightmare with his ex-bed. He's got a down bed that he took to, Switzerland. And he's just blown it up and all the seals, all the heat seals have popped and it's like a massive floppy quilt. So that's the second time that's done that to him. So he is unimpressed, aren't you, Scott?
Not impressed with X-Bed, I'm afraid.
Mm.
I'm going to get rid of it if they replace it and get a Sea to Summit.
Yeah, Sea to Summit one. We're going to we'll keep you updated on what happens with that, whether they replace it. Because that ain't on. That's a nearly £200 mattress. That is terrible. Luckily, I bought a Thermarest for Marley in the Quasar, so Scott's going to sleep on that on top of his. Sorted. Lucy blitz the wine, now it's like mulled wine.
Yep.
Well, it is like winter out there. Cheers. We've decided that we're going to sleep in here because the weather outside is atrocious. The wind is really kicking up, 30 mile an hour plus. I know it doesn't sound a lot, but when you've got this on offer, why are you going to set your tent up out in that? I'll take you outside. Hang on, let me put my head torch on. It's very damp in here. There you go, look. Yeah. Right, round the corner, excuse the wind.
Oh, yeah. That's fierce.
Oh, there's Marley. Let's get you out the wind, there's Marley. Hopefully you can hear me because my dead cat is soaking wet and frozen. The body's taking a bit of a paste in the snow tonight and it is cold. It's My little gadget says minus 15 wind chill, and they predicted, minus 13 tonight. It is really cold, it's fantastic. And yet, we got a bit of snow that I wanted. There's Marley. But you can see it's really, it's not thick, about a centimetre, 2 centimetres, but it's bitterly cold. What? So, fantastic. Just what I wanted.
I got my snow, Eddie.
The Foel Grach shelter. Whew. Refuge.
You're not actually meant to sleep the night. You're not allowed to plan to sleep the night, but I think we're justified tonight because, as you know, we have got the tents, but putting them up in this ain't much fun when you've got a shelter like this, why not?
Blimey. Marley's rolling in the snow, you nutter. Come on, mate, let's go in. Come on.
Like I said, we're all sleeping in here, so we've got the old foam silver thing down. Alright, come on, Marley. Let's shut that door. That is cold. Cold night. Okay.
And God, we're glad this is here today. What we've decided to do tomorrow is we may head down to, what's it called?
Dulyn.
Dulyn Bothy, not far away. Down at the two lakes we crossed between. And then we're going to leave a load of stuff there. Lucy's going to stay there. Me and Scott are going to walk back to the car, go and buy a load of firewood, and we're going to spend the night there because we don't think the weather's not getting any better and it's going to rain tomorrow night, apparently. It's not going to be this cold. But we're making the most of this. This is brilliant. So I'll catch up with you a bit later.
Okay, we're all set for bed. There's Scott. Sorry about the light in the face, Scott. There's Scott in bed there. Look. Lucy, Marley, he's got his own Montane jacket as a quilt. And there's me. As you can see, the walls absolutely frozen.
I'm absolutely boiling.
Yeah. Lucy's got a new bag, I should mention it. It's one of those OEX ones from Go Outdoors. It's called a
Leviathan.
Evolution. But you got it off on
Outdoor Returns.
Outdoor Returns on eBay.
When somebody buys something and they don't particularly like it, they take it back and they can't sell it as new.
Yeah, so when someone buys something from Go Outdoors and they can't sell it as new, this place is an outlet for them. And what did you pay for that?
80 quid.
80 quid. And it's virtually
200 quid.
Yeah, it's virtually 200 quid's worth. So what a result, and it's mega boiling. Warm and big.
I'm boiling.
good.
I right. Am toasty.
Yeah, so Scott's all right. He's happy.
We're going to go to bed, so see you in the morning. Good night. Good morning, welcome back. As you can see, it didn't warm up much. Great night, really. A bit tossed and turned a little bit.
There's the shelter. At least you can see it now in the daylight. Like I said, I don't know how the sound's going to come out because the bed cat's frozen solid.
But look at this.
Proper bit of cold last night, just what we wanted.
Does that dog ever get cold?
Good boy.
It's a doggy snow angel. You all right, mister?
Yeah, good boy. So, we had a good night, like I said. Whoa. It's probably about 9 o'clock. We've packed up all the bags and stuff, but oh, excuse the wind. Let me go behind here. Oh, that's better. That's better. Yeah, we've packed up all the bags, all the sleeping mats and stuff like that after Scott's debacle with his, just in case someone came. But as you can see, the conditions look. What is it? 60, 70 foot visibility. Minus 15 wind chill. It's minus 5 out here now. Minus 2 in the shelter last night. So it was brilliant. We tested all the equipment. Lucy's new bag, absolutely cracking. Look at these patterns.
There's the window to the bottom. And my nutty dog.
Plan for today. We're going to drop down the way we came and then head off left between the lakes, and we're going to go to Dulyn Bothy. And then the plan is me and Scott are going to go back to the car and get a load of firewood. Lucy's going to stay in the Bothy, and then we should have a nice warm, roomy night with a table. So we shall see, but not the wild camp we expected.
Right, we're all done. We will see you at the next stop. That's it, secure.
Great stuff. We're off. We're gonna descend now.
I don't know, 400 metres, not too much.
That's where we stayed tonight, thank you very much. And that's where we're headed. So, onwards. That's the trail we came up on, but everything's changed. So, I'm using the GPS just to follow the course down. You can see the big arrows and the double blue line. So, it shouldn't be able to go wrong. Guys, right, we're back out the clag. There's Lucy, Scott, you see the snow on the ground thinning. And there we are, we've broken out between the two lakes. Dulyn's off to the left and that's where the Bothy is. We've just come down through there, round that boulder, down that path and across the wall. Follow the pipe down. Where Scott and Lucy are going, that's where the Bothy is. Right, we're out the wind, out the snow. Here's our water supply. Lucy's just filling up the Ortley bag. This is fed from Dulyn Reservoir, just there in the gap behind the big wall. Nice clean water, lovely and clean actually. And there's Scott just getting to the Bothy. Dulyn Bothy. And Marley's buggered off with him. There were 9 people in there last night. We just met a couple going up there.
And there was 9 of them in there last night, but apparently there's a few left, but no one's intending to stay the night. So, and hopefully they've left some coal and wood, we hear. So we might just sit here for the day after all and chill out.
Welcome to Dulyn Bothy.
There you go. Dulyn Bothy, 21st of November.
We are having a snack. We've made it down to the lake, as you saw. And this is what it's like. It's loads of mats left, usual stuff. Loads of food, loads of cooking utensils, gas, you name it. Lovely log burner. Some kind people left us their wood. They were here when we got here, so we've got a little bit of coal, a few bits of wood to chop up. So that'll keep us warm later on. This is the obviously the kitchen and your social area. And then in here is the sleeping area. Look at the size of it, so that's where me and Lula are going. Scott's over there.
It's not nice weather.
But it's raining outside now, so. Thank
you.
It's a really good little Bothy, this one.
Little horse down there, look at the ponies. Yep.
It's pretty grim out there.
So we're all set up. We're gonna have a doss about, have some food, cup of coffee, warm up, and then Sue might take a walk up the lake later. We'll see how it goes. Oh yeah, all good.
Right, we're making an emergency dash back to the car for supplies. Well, actually for wine.
So I'm taking the tents back and stuff like that that we're not going to use tonight because we're in the bovey. So yeah, we're going to head on out and hopefully, so it'll be about 5 mile round trip.
My microphone's not plugged in.
And my microphone isn't plugged in, so, but this should get the sound all right. So yeah, there we go.
It's an emergency situation.
There you go.
I've got to look after base camp.
See you out there.
What a lovely backdrop for the bovey. There's Scott.
See ya!
Good as well, we'll give Marley a bit more exercise which will calm him down tonight.
Water's running off around me.
Put to the tool jar, sunshine.
Okay, excuse the wind.
There's our car down there, so we're going to go and have a 10-minute break because we're knackered, and that was a lot harder.
As usual, excuse my runny nose, as usual, that was a lot harder than we thought it would be. Wetter, boggy, the whole lot. So we're just going to get this walk finished
and have a 10-minute rest at the car, have a little snack, and then head back up where we've just come from.
Wonderful.
But
look.
Oh yeah, I won't have the old quasar in my backpack. I've got Scott's tent, his duff sleeping mat, my spare sleeping mat because he's using the foam ones in the body. So I'm going to be probably about 8 kilos lighter. So happy days.
Okay, let's get to the car.
Hello guys. Right, that's us. We've had a rest. Just had a nice chat to those people down by their car. And we're heading back up again. So, we've got an hour and a quarter to an hour and a half's light less.
We've got our head torches, so I guess we'll be finishing this one off in the dark, but it's all good. Right, back to the bothy.
Hello guys, right, we are back at the bothy, thank heavens. That was hard going, really mushy and so, but mission accomplished. About a litre and a half of wine, or just under. And Scott's doing fire duties. Look at that, we're gonna have a nice fire going in here soon. Take the damp out, yeah. So, good stuff, we're gonna look at the
candles.
We're gonna chill out for a little while, and have some noodles, replenish the energy we just used. Crock pot was tiring.
Marley steaming away.
Good morning. Eventful night, very windy, very rainy. Molly's just finishing off Scott's breakfast. Got tea on the go, lovely.
About 8:30, 8:45 last night, we were all locked up, we got the fire going.
Four lads turned up.
They've just left us, there they go this morning, and I don't need to explain how bad the weather is, look at this. Good job we've only got an hour back to the car. They're going back to the car park we came from. But yeah, four lads turned up. One of them's got work this afternoon, so he had to leave by about 8:30 this morning. But yeah, so
body tidied up, swept up, all clean. Marley has injured his leg. He's not happy bunny. This foot is all swollen, so he's really stiff and limping, and we've still got about 2.5 miles back to the car,
so it's going to be a hard walk for him, but nothing we can do about that. That's the trouble with him getting older now. So he's down there feeling sorry for himself, but we're all done, so we're going to leave this fantastic little body. We're going to put the fire out in a minute before we go. I don't see what else we can do apart from shovel it out and put some water on it, but hopefully it's calming down a bit. Let's have a look. There's the shit shovel.
It don't look good.
Not the best. Okay, so we're going to go back to the car now. We're going to brave these crappy conditions. We knew it would be like this. That's why we thought it would be best to come to the Bothy, because once the freeze line went too high, it all turns to rain, doesn't it? Never mind. Okay, see you back at the car.
Well, you want good boots in weather like this. Marley, you did well, mate. Good boy.
Right, here we are back at the car. As you can see, crap weather, but what a brilliant camp. We've had all sorts of weather thrown at us. Hope you can hear me. So, thank you very much for joining us on this one, and we'll see you again on the next one. Cheers, bye-bye.